Hey, it's Olena with OlenaHofmeyer.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make this beautiful rose flower. And watch until the end so you can get the free pattern, including what materials I'm using, plus a bonus tip. Starting off with part one, which is the base, you're going to chain two, single crochet six in the second chain from the hook. And we're going to work in front loops only for the next few rounds. So for round two, working in the front loops only, we're going to increase in each stitch. So increasing is just making two stitches in one from the previous round. So here you have your back loop and your front loop, and usually you work underneath both, but this time we're just going to grab the front loop. So we're going to increase. Round one was six stitches. At the end of this round, we're going to have 12. So that was 1, 2, 3, 4. And continue in the front loops only till the end of the round. For round three, you're going to work in the front loops only. You're going to single crochet in the first and increase in the next for a total of 18 stitches at the end of the round. I'm going to do one, and here I like to insert my stitch marker, increase in the next. So two, after you finished round three, I just like to bring my tail to the front, and we'll be working in the back for part two, which is making the petals. You're going to work in the front loops when making your petals. So you just slip stitch to the next front loops only, chain three, 5 triple crochet in that same stitch or hole that you just joined in. So triple crochet is yarning over twice. Put your hook in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over, pull through the 2 remaining loops. Repeat that 4 times. Yarn over twice, put your hook in the same hole, yarn over, pull through. That's 2, 3, 4, 5. Now chain 3, slip stitch in the next front loop, slip stitch in the next again, and repeat. Chain 3, 5 triple crochet, chain 3, and do this around. Repeat this for a total of 9 petals. I'm on my last petal, so here I chain 3. I'm going to just slip stitch, and then we're going to slip stitch to the back. So we're going to now work in these back loops. So slip stitch into the back loop of the first petal. And you finished this petal. Just flip your flower over. You see this next hole? Stick your hook into the loop and slip stitch to join. And we're going to slip stitch into the next. So now when we make our petal, it's going to be in the center of these two, making it look really nice. Chain three, five triple crochets into that same hole. Chain three again, slip stitch into the center of the next petal, into that loop that's by the center, and slip stitch into the next loop. So this petal is in the center of these two. And continue around. You will have eight petals in this round where you had nine petals in the previous round. When you finish round five, we're going to start on round six. So at round end of round five, you have eight petals, and you can go ahead and count those. This is my 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On the next round, six, we're going to have five petals. So you can go ahead and attach your yarn, or just grab this loop here in the back. Slip stitch and then slip stitch into the next. So again, your next petal will be in between the two from the previous round. This is what it's looking like right now. Going to chain three and then four triple crochet into that same hole. So instead of five, we're doing four now. And then you slip stitch to the next loop. And slip stitch to the next. Repeat around. So you will have five petals on this round six. At the end of round six, I've chained three, then I'm going to join to the next loop. And then for round seven, I'm going to join to the next available loop. This is the last one, so you can either join in the first or the last. I'm just gonna go here. Yeah, to the last. So as you can see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 petals. And slip stitch into the next. Gets a little tight at this point. Chain three, 3 triple crochet into the same hole as join. Chain 3, slip stitch to the next. Slip stitch to the next loop. And repeat. You will have 3 petals at the end of this round. Here I'm on my last petal, chain 3, and slip stitch anywhere you can find to join. You can see 1, 2, 3. Fasten off here. And stick your hook through the bottom to pull that tail inside. Pull that tail through. And there's your beautiful flower. I encourage you to play with textures, use different yarns, bulky, all kinds of different yarns. Now for the bonus, you can add a stem and leaves. Make a lot of these and make a bouquet. You can attach this to a hair clip. You can attach it to a hair elastic. So for the stem, to use green, I'm going to chain 4, and slip stitch to join to make a circle. Single crochet 4 around. Rounds 2 through 32, or as long as you would like them, you just single crochet around. So 4 stitches around. And you could work around your pipe cleaner to make the stem flexible. You don't have to use a pipe cleaner. Once you come up to the edge of the pipe cleaner, you could just pull a little bit up and continue working. Once you've finished single crocheting 32 rounds or more, you could just join to the next stitch. Bind off, fasten off. Then you'll need to attach your leaves to make the leaves. You're going to chain 11. Single crochet in the second chain from the hook. Single crochet in the next. Half double crochet in the next 2 chains. Double crochet in the next 2 chains. Half double crochet in the next 2. single crochet in the next. And then in the last chain, you're going to do a few stitches, so single crochet in there, chain three, slip stitch to the first, to the third chain from the hook. This is called a picot. Then single crochet in that same hole. Then you're going to work on the opposite side of the chain, so back, going back down here, single crochet in the next. You just need to find the hole. And I like to work over my yarn tail, so weave it in as I go. Half double crochet in the next two. Double crochet in the next two. Half double crochet in the next two. And then single crochet in the last two. Slip stitch to the first stitch to join. Leave a long tail for sewing and make two more for a total of three. Using your large eye blunt needle, let's go ahead and attach your leaves. You can cut off the pipe cleaner too if it's too long and sticking out. Just attach them anywhere you'd like. I like to grab a little bit stitch up, so then it kind of pulls my leaf up, pointing upwards a little bit. So then you just stick all your ends inside. You can weave the tails in a little bit, so you can make sure they don't come loose. And you could always use your hook to pull the tails inside. This will be a little tight, since you got that pipe cleaner in there. If you do, just pull them in there. Or you can cut them off, but I like to just pull them inside. You'll need a little bit of yarn to sew your flower to the top of the stem. You can make a whole bunch of these. Mother's Day, Valentine's Day would be perfect. Even like Carnation Day at school. This flat piece is the bottom, so you got your petals at the top. Just tie a few knots. Again, you can use your hook to bring in the leftovers into the flower, into the stem. manipulate your flower any way you want. A wilted flower. Another idea you can do is wrap yarn around your pipe cleaner using a glue gun. So we're gonna go ahead and put a little bit of glue onto our pipe cleaner. If you don't wanna crochet the whole thing around because it is a little bit finicky, that's still just another idea. Another idea would be to attach a hair clip to the back of the flower. Last idea is to single crochet around a hair elastic and then attach or glue on your flower to one side. So you just go ahead and join, single crochet around. When you've single crocheted 60 around, you're just going to join to the first stitch, bind off. You can leave a longer tail, then you're just going to sew your flower on to this end. When you're working, make sure your work is not twisted when you join. Now you know how to make your rose flower, but do you know what materials to use? No problem. I've got a free written pattern for you. Click the link in the description to download it now. I design one pattern a week, so if you have a suggestion, please put it in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a like, thumbs up. Share this video with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.